Show. That's the latest. I'm Tim Jones.
The Jazz FM Money Minute.
Well, the number of homes sold has risen sharply thanks to the typical spring bounce, while the pickup could also be a sign that some buyers brought forward purchases to benefit from the stamp duty concession, which has now expired. The UK government borrowed more than expected in March, but still met its borrowing target for the year. Although previous month's borrowing was revised down, meaning the government met its target of £126 billion. Associated British Foods has announced a 3% rise in profits thanks to strong performances from its Primark retail chain and its sugar business. Carpet writers again warned that its profits will be lower than previously forecast, blaming disappointing bed sales in the country and weak trading. While tax officials have welcomed a ruling that prevents a group of wealthy investors from claiming more than £100 million in tax relief, the case surrounded a deal in film distribution rights and involved investors including Manchester United manager Sir Alex Ferguson. To our stock market coverage with Alpari, and it was a better day for the FTSE, which rose 44 points, closing at 5,709. I'm Johnny Hart.
The Jazz FM Money Minute. Jazz Travels with Robbie Vincent.
Jazz FM. Listening colour.
Robbie Vincent with Jazz Travels, Music and Travel. This is where we talk to musicians, movers and shakers, those in the travel industry, to find out where they would take us, looking for perhaps places we wouldn't normally visit. My guest is Roddy McNear. More about that in a second. You just heard Dancing on the Floor, Third World. They were one of the artists playing at the South African Jazz Festival. We have a South Africa season starting next week, and they will be included in that South Africa season. Joining me will be Mike Vitti, who becomes Ranger Vitti to Music Vitti. I'm delighted to say this evening our guest is Roddy McNear. He's a four top. He makes solo albums too. A fine musician, a fine singer. But Roddy, everybody on this program gets asked more or less the same thing. What sort of things did you hear at home growing up?
Oh, man, yes. All kind, blues, jazz, mostly blues, jazz, R&B, mostly, and gospel.
You were born in a place called Camden, which I can't see the world jumping up and down saying, I know where that is. Camden in Alabama, which is a tiny place. We didn't stay there very long, did you?
No. Matter of fact, I'll tell you where it is. If you ever saw any of the documentaries on Martin Luther King and the march from Selma to Birmingham, or no, Selma to Montgomery, there is a sign that says Camden, 35 miles. So it's 35, so we're known for something. It's 35 miles out of Selma, which is about 62 miles south of Montgomery, Alabama.
I know as a baby you were moved out of Camden. You went to Michigan, didn't you?
Yeah.
Did you just go back to Camden on a regular basis?
Every year of my life till I got 17 years old, my dad would take me back down on the farm when school was out, and we stayed like at least a week or two every year.
Because the difference between the two places, I mean, Michigan, very, very industrial, and I guess as countryfied as you could get in Camden.
Man, look, I remember, let me tell you something. What the good thing was about being down there is it taught me to appreciate the simple things in life. I mean, it made me appreciate a toilet, because they had outhouses. When I was a little kid, man, I was a little growing up, man, you had to go out at night. You know, at night, you had to use what they call the chamber pot. You know, they had a nickname for it down there, called them slop jars. But you had to use that at night, and nobody was going out in the summer at nighttime. You got snakes crawling all around into an outhouse, and I couldn't even stand it in the daytime, man. So, we had to go to, I remember some of the kids that would have to get water, their well was like maybe 100 yards or more away from the house. Our well was like maybe 40, 50 feet, 90 feet maybe from the house. But these guys, and they would be barefoot walking around, you know, it made me appreciate all kind of stuff living there.
And appreciate the fact you had indoor toilets, loos, John's, whatever you want to call them, in Michigan. If you were the tourist officer for Camden, Alabama, and the surroundings, and you wanted to encourage people to visit that part of America, what would you say are the pluses? I mean, the outside loos, I guess, aren't so many now?
Well, at this point, it's really because of the economy and the way things are going now, it probably wouldn't be a good place to even go.
All right, then we'll send us to Michigan.
Same thing. I'll take that. I'm just kidding, man.
No, but you could say, if you want to get a feel of how tough things can be in an apparently very rich nation, I've got two places for you to go. Industrial Michigan,
right.
Country village-style life in Camden.
Industrial Michigan, where there's not industry anymore like it used to be. You know, you can imagine a place where the car industry was flourishing through 30, 40 years. Then all of a sudden now it's not, you know, plants are closed. And, you know, and most of the people from down south came up north for those kind of jobs. And now you don't have them. And, man, everything has gone amok. So
where'd you live now?
I'm back. I just came from living in Las Vegas for 20 years. And they ran me out of Vegas. You know, the machines ran me out of Vegas. So got my head back on straight. I came back to Michigan, so I stay in Bloomfield, Michigan, which is about 10 minutes from Pontiac, Michigan, where I was raised.
Are you a gambler?
I'm trying to not be one as bad now. And I can tell you right now, if you're a gambler out there, stop. It's the worst thing I ever was involved in my life.
And did you become a gambler because you're in Las Vegas?
Yes. Well, yes and no.
Did it infect you?
Yes, it infected me. When I left Michigan, only thing I played was the lottery. You know, they have like your lottery you play, and I played that too much. So I guess gambling was in my blood, you know. But I never really was a real gambler, like shooting dice and that kind of stuff, or card playing. But when the lottery came, numbers, you know, I started playing it. But when I went to Las Vegas, they got every bet you want to, whatever bet you want to make, they got it there. And through the years, the first 5 years, I gradually turned into a habitual gambler.
Robbie Vincent with Jazz Travels on Jazz FM. Our guest is Ronnie McNair. Tell me you're not fooling me. Ronnie, I want to know what made you go to Las Vegas in the first place.
I went to Las Vegas because in Detroit, and like Pontiac is like 25 miles north of Detroit. So it's like the metropolitan area. It might as well stay Detroit. So things weren't going that well for me musically. Not too many places to play, to perform. So my career wasn't doing too good. So I said, well, let me go to another area. And at least Las Vegas, you could play the showrooms and the lounges and you could work. And when I went out there, I got a great story, man, of when I first got there, I went around in my car and dropped off a tape and a picture at these different, I would ride by and say, well, would I want to play in there? And if it was a place I thought was pretty good, I'd go in and give them a tape and a picture. This one lady called me up. And it was a little place called the Baby Grand club. One night I'm in there playing, and I heard this trombone playing, and I kept looking around. The place wasn't big enough. I said, couldn't find out where it was. Right there at the end of the piano, a guy was sitting down doing it with his mouth. And you know who it was? George Kirby. George Kirby was a great comedian from the States years ago, and he was one of those impressionists. So then he started blowing the trumpet. I sent the mic to him, and I mean, it sounded just like it was me and a trumpet player, and I mean, that was one of my great experiences there.
So if you're in America, perhaps in a bar or a small area for playing of music, and you can hear somebody playing the trumpet and there are no trumpets, now you know it's probably that comedian. Wonderful story. We'll be back with more from Ronnie McNear, and of course, some more of his music and some more of his words.
Jazz FM.
With the latest traffic and travel news when you need it, 7 days a week. In partnership with Rail Easy.
I'm Simon Temby with the latest Jazz FM traffic and travel. The southbound side of the M5 through Somerset has a lane closed off. Traffic is slow because of an accident from junction 23 at Bridgewater North through to 24 at the Bridgewater South turn meeting with the A38. The southbound side of the M18 through South Yorkshire is queuing. A lane's closed on the slip road from the M1. So trying to get onto the M18 from the M1 at Thurcroft. That's the M1's junction 32. The matrix signs are set to 50 miles an hour. The M6 northbound around Manchester, traffic is slow because of an accident involving three vehicles earlier on from junction 26 at the All Interchange to 27 at Standish. And the M74 northbound through South Lanarkshire, there's delays. The lane's closed off because of an accident from junction 11 through to 10 at Les Mahago. Anything else? So 559 27 27.
Jazz FM Traffic and Travel with Rail Easy. For an easy journey to and from work, book cheap tickets at raileasy.com.
Jazz FM's Listening Colour.
Hello there, welcome to Asda. Can I help you?
I want long-lasting power!
Okay, I expect you're looking for the UK's favourite battery brand, Duracell.
Yes, my devices need the power.
Well, you'll be pleased to know that you can get Plus Power Cells AA and AAA 4-packs at 2 for £3.75 right here in Asda.
Bargain.
You can even join in the fun and visit Bunny on Facebook at facebook.com/Duracell UK.
I love Bunny.
All right then, Asda, saving you money every day.
UK's favourite battery brand, supported by 55.5% volume sales share in battery market over the last 12 months from EBOS data.
Jazz FM.
Gavin, 31, technician for Autoglass.
My last customer was saving for a family break. He didn't think about his chip windscreen, then he was on the school run and crack, with the kids in the car. He called Autoglass and replaced the screen, but it cost his big excess. That dampened his holiday plans, especially as it could have been avoided. If he'd called when he first saw the chip, I could have repaired it before it cracked. All technicians at Autoglass are experts using the latest tools and technology. Like our unique resin, you'll only find it at Autoglass. It stays strongest for longest and means you get a lifetime guarantee for as long as you own your car. Plus, if you fully comp, our repairs are usually free for you and won't affect you no claims. So you can save your money for the things that really matter.
For vehicle glass, demand Autoglass. Call 0800 234 234 or visit autoglass.co.uk.
One more thing, most insurers recommend Autoglass. They work with us to make your life easier. So call us direct and we'll do the rest.
Autoglass repair. Autoglass replace. Britain. Now is the time to make your home better off. Let's not pay too much for our broadband when we could each be saving £154 with TalkTalk versus BT. Let's sign up to the Essentials Home Phone and Broadband package and enjoy our first 6 months free, then a mere £6.50 a month after that. Let's visit TalkTalk.co.uk before Wednesday the 23rd of May and be better off. TalkTalk, a brighter home for everyone. Line rental £14.50, minimum contract and conditions apply, based on BT 40 gig broadband and evening and weekend calls over 18 months.
Cash flow. It's the heartbeat of every business. But when payments are late, your business is under pressure. At Lloyds TSB, we can't stop late payments, but we could stop them impacting your business. We can talk to you about invoice finance solutions, which could release your money owed from invoices within as little as 24 hours. Because keeping the cash flowing keeps your business going. To find out more, go to lloydstsb.com/cashflow. Lloyds TSB. For the journey. Lending is subject to status.
And relax. There's 50% off Vivo Collection sofas at DFS. Half price savings end Sunday. DFS. Making every day more comfortable.
If you need to relax and unwind after the rigours of a long day, join me, Helen Mayhew, here each weekday evening for the cool and mellow music of Dinner Jazz, an elegant mix of classic and current recordings. It's an oasis of calm in a hectic world. So I'll see you here from 7 on Jazz FM.
If you got any love for me left in your heart, please give me another chance. It's a letter from a fool. I'm confessing to you, babe, I broke the golden rule.
With Jazz Travels, Travel and Music. Our guest is Ronnie McNear. He's a four top. That's a track from his most recent album, Letter from a Fool.
Where did the Motown days fit into this then? Was that before Vegas, after Vegas, in the middle? Where did it fit?
It was before, way before Vegas. When I first started playing piano, I was about 10 or 11. My dad put me in piano lessons. He bought a new piano and it had 6 weeks free lessons. I was the oldest kid of three. And they put me in. I didn't even want to do it, man. I didn't want to do this stuff. But I'm so grateful today that they made me do it. And I went on about 6 months. We went through the 6 weeks free, and then they paid 6 months. But then I started wanting to play what I heard on the radio. And my piano teacher said, well, I said, I don't want to play this no more. I'm tired of playing this lullaby and all this stuff. So I want to play what I hear on the radio. The teacher said, well, if you want to play that, you have to learn how to do this first. I said, if I got to do this first, I don't want to do it no more. So they stopped my lessons, but I went on by ear. And as I was playing, when I got about 14 or 15 years old, I had a chance to start writing my own song. And I had a tryout at Motown. They didn't want me as a singer, but they wanted me as a writer. But my dad just wanted me to be a real, you know, recording artist, singer. So he should have went on and let him sign me as a writer. But we didn't know anything about music business. You know, I didn't have a manager. He was my manager, but he was the greatest one I ever had, because he was the greatest promotion man I ever had in my life, my dad. I did a record called Sitting in My Class that you might know about, with a record company called Detroit Sound. And I was 17. Then right after that, I signed with RCA in 72. Motown was right after that, 76.
What would your highlights and your thoughts of Motown be, if you had to sum them up in a few words? For someone really young who didn't understand Motown, how would you sum up your experiences?
My experience with Motown was one of the greatest that I could ever have, because I learned a lot. I was with Berry Gordy a lot, and where a lot of people wasn't with him a lot back there. You know, some people that even were at the company never really got to be in his company. But anytime I had a problem, I'd call up and say, hey, I want to talk to Mr. Gordy, you know, and he would see me. And I learned about the company. I would go up there every day to see what they were doing. I'd walk around the company. I'd walk around all the departments and see how they really ran it. And one thing about him, he never denied seeing me, and I learned a lot.
Arda Berry Gordy, the boss of Motown's Empire, the Four Tops, Baby I Need Your Lovin', classic I Can't Help Myself, another classic. Big boots for somebody to fill, isn't it, to become a member of the Four Tops?
That was like a fairy tale story. I was Bernardo Benson, who really adopted me out of high school. And as you know, he wrote What's Going On. Did you know that? That he wrote What's Going On, Save the Children from Marvin, and Holy, Holy, Holy. Anyway, we met up, and man, we just hit it off, started writing songs, and he really just took me in like I was a young brother, you know, of his. And so as the years went by, we wrote and wrote, and around year 2000, I was in Las Vegas being ridiculous, gambling my money up, being stupid, and at this particular time, I wasn't working in the lounge. So George Roundtree, who was the musical director for the Four Tops, got sick with a kidney ailment. He had to go out, so Obie said, give Ronnie the job. Because I didn't have, wasn't working then. So I was just playing the piano. I was not conducting or doing any of the music directing. So anyway, I came in and played the piano and for about a couple of months, about a month and a half. And then George came back. So the Four Tops told me, they said, the organization said, look, we want you to stay. Stay and do what? They said, we want you to be a safety valve just in case if he gets sick again, you know, maybe, you know, if he goes into toxic shock or anything. And Obie knew, though, that I could do either one. If I had to sing, I could do it. If I had to play, I could do it. So I said, okay. So they paid me to travel around with them, to just stand around, and you know. And
for, you were like a reserve top.
There you go. And for a while, I got kind of bored with that. And they would come and tell me, hey, man, you okay now? This is a real job now. Don't think you just, you know, because I did feel. I said, man, I'd rather go back to gamble. You know, maybe I might get lucky. I said, but I stayed there, and lo and behold, 4 months later, Levi Stubbs got sick. Before one of the engagements, we were opening up for the Beach Boys. I said, well, I can do it. And he looked at me, he said, Ronnie, can you? I said, look, man, it's now or never. I'm not going to keep standing around like this. He said, oh, man, can you? I said, yeah, if I put my tuxedo on and go up there and be the fourth man, you'll get paid. He said, yeah. So before I could put my tuxedo on, the wardrobe man said, man, come here. See, can you wear these pants? And they threw Levi's pants on me. They fit good enough. I had to wear them low so I wouldn't flood, you know. And so Levi had long arms, and his coat fit me perfect. I went out, and at that time, they had a singer named Theo Peoples that had come from the Temptations that was with him. He was there 2 years before I got there. Theo and I went up there, and we did 3 nights and saved them big money for 3 nights straight. And after that, they saw that I could come in, and when Levi didn't feel, because it was on his last, right before he was getting ready to retire, and that was 2000, and Levi would come to me and say, hey, man, suit up. I said, you here? I don't feel like it. So from July to December of 2000, I filled in for him when he didn't feel like it. And ever since January of 2001, I became a full-fledged four-top.
But what's so good about being the spare four-top and then becoming a four-top? It did give you a lot of space, didn't it, to do the Ronnie McNair albums. And here's an example. Everybody's in a Hurry, one of my favourites. Here it comes.
Always be in a hurry, going nowhere fast. Always taking advantage of situations that you know won't last. Well, you know, we gotta stop this. Gotta get yourself together. Slow down, I know you wanna stay around. Speed down the highway, you got a hot date. You ain't thinking about your safety, just as long as you don't be late. The lady over there, her body is strange, cause she hangs out night after night, doing those same old devilish things. Some people think they're awful slick, talking fast, playing all kind of tricks. If we don't learn to really slow down, we're only speeding up our chances, not really round.
down life road. That kind of life won't last. The man over here, his mind is surely gone, cause he don't know if he's coming or going. He's so all alone. Some people think they're awful sick, talking fast, making all kinds of tricks. If we don't learn to really slow down, we're only speeding up our chances of not being around.
Everybody's in a hurry.
Robbie Vincent, Jazz FM, it's Jazz Travels, Jazz and Travel. My guest is Ronnie McNear. We've been talking about how being a reserve top turns you into a full-time top. That was one of my favourite Ronnie McNear cuts. Now, travelling with the four tops, everybody I talk to says the thing they hate most is hotels. Are you one of those?
No, I'm not. I love hotel living. I love it, man. You know, from the dumps. Well, I don't really like a dump hotel, but I like being out there on the road. I love it, you know. I just like it. I don't know what it is. It's like I got the best of two worlds. When I'm home and I get bored, I know I'm going on the road. When I'm on the road and I get sick of on the road, I can go back home. Or when I'm off not doing anything, I can go somewhere else if I want to. So you're blessed with that, you know.
Because there's a bit of what do old, and I'm not suggesting you are old, but this thing about...
I'm old.
let me rephrase it in a polite way. we are men of a certain age, aren't we? You and me. We're over 30. It was Jim Mullen, who's a fine, fine guitarist. Something stuck with me. He said, well, if you Duke Ellington, what do? You go home and do the ironing and do the washing and mow the lawn? He said, of course you don't. He said, you can't retire. And musicians are a bit like that. They find it nigh on impossible to retire.
Man, you want to keep going till you drop dead. That's just where it is. You don't know anything. What else do you know to do? That's what it is. In anything, I don't care if you were a mechanic or you were in the cleaning business, what are you going to stop and take and start a new career all of a sudden? You know, it's just the way, like my dad said, the way the cookie crumbles. You do what you got to do.
Our guest is Ronnie McNear. We hear from one of his favorite jazz pianists in just a moment.
Jazz FM.
With the latest traffic and travel news when you need it, 7 days a week. In partnership with Rail Easy.
I'm Simon Temby with the latest Jazz FM traffic and travel. The southbound side of the M5 has a lane closed off because of an accident from Bridgewater North at junction 23 to 24 at the Bridgewater South turn meeting with the A38. Lane 1 on the three-lane stretch is closed off. The M4, the second Severn crossing on the westbound side through Bristol, is closed off because of a serious accident involving three vehicles from junction 21 at the M48 set through to 23 at McGaw. It's an accident which happened just before the toll plaza, and the closure's been implemented from junction 21 to allow traffic to use the M48 instead. The M18 southbound through South Yorkshire is slow, a lane's close on the exit slip road at the M1 to junction 32 at Thurcroft, and the A90 eastbound through Perth and Kinross slow at Burnfoot. 0500 59 27 27.
Jazz FM Traffic and Travel with Rail Easy. Avoid the traffic with cheap and easy to book trains at RailEasy.com.
Jazz FM's listening colour.
Hello there. Welcome to Asda. Can I help you?
I want long-lasting power.
Okay, I expect you're looking for the UK's favourite battery brand, Duracell.
Yes, my devices need the power.
Well, you'll be pleased to know that you can get Plus Power Cells AA and AAA 4-packs at 2 for £3.75 right here in Asda.
Bargain!
You can even join in the fun and visit Bunny on Facebook at facebook.com/Duracell UK.
I love Bunny.
All right then, Asda, saving you money every day.
UK's favourite battery brand, supported by 55.5% volume sales share of battery market over the last 12 months from EBOS data.
Jazz FM.
Jazz FM, in association with Sirius and Band on the Wall, present Marcus Miller, live in concert in London and Manchester. See the legendary Marcus Miller, playing live in London on May the 4th at the Royal Festival Hall, and in Manchester on Sunday, May the 6th at the HMV Ritz.
Hey, this is Marcus Miller, and I'm really looking forward to performing in London and Manchester.
This is Mike Vitti, and I'll be at the HMV Ritz too, for a special Funky Sensation DJ set, just ahead of Marcus hitting the stage. So why don't you join Jazz FM Bank Holiday Weekend? Tickets are available right now at jazzfm.com. Marcus Miller, live in concert.
See you there.
Only with Jazz FM.
And the winner is Nissan Qashqai.
Qashqai.
It's official. The Nissan Qashqai is the best used car in the UK, with awards from both What Car and CAP, the used car pricing experts. So, to celebrate, we're holding a special win-win event from the 26th to the 29th of April, with great deals across the Nissan cared-for used car range. Buy during the event and get a free Virgin Experience day of your choice, anything from spa days to track days. Add all the reassurance of Nissan cared for, and it's a real win-win. Google Nissan cared for full terms and conditions. You can tell when a used car is cared for.
Cared for.
Once upon a time, a girl opened a pack of new Jacob's Oddities crackers and got on the ring, ring, to call a wah, who was playing against a wah, wah, to ask to borrow his to take a picture of an oiler sitting on a new wah, 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 shaped Jacob's Oddities. They're baked, they're crispy, they're crackers. And they're in the crackers aisle now.
Paul, a terrific performance today. You must be over the moon to have made the UEFA finals. Some huge games coming up. Tell me, how hard did you work to get here?
Not much, Brian. All I had to do was pick up a promotional pack of Castrol. Went online and won tickets. Dead easy.
For great car performance and the chance to win tickets for Euro 2012, plus thousands of other prizes, top up your oil today with Castrol. Castrol. It's more than just oil. It's liquid engineering. Available in leading supermarkets, garages and DIY stores. Visit winwith.castrol.com for terms and conditions. Offer ends September 30th.
This is Jazz FM.
Robbie Vincent, Jazz Travels on Jazz FM. Our guest is Four Top, Ronnie McNear. And that was Oscar Peterson and the A-Train, one of Ronnie's favourite jazz pianists.
You were saying you're one of the rare people who actually likes being on the road and actually likes hotel life. Tell me, what is a good hotel to Ronnie? What really makes you say, I've been in a few hotels, but I love the way they do this or do that?
When they have good room service, when I have a good view out my window, you know, I don't care where it is. It could be the countryside, but as long as I'm not looking at the roof of somebody's house or the roof of a building, you know, things like that matter to me now. I like, even at home, man, I sit and look out the window and reminisce, you know, memories. I think one of the greatest things of life is to be able to remember. And how we got that, I don't know, but I'm glad that I can remember, man.
Well, remember some of the nice, in your mind, you said that you like a nice view and you like good room service. But what about places you go to? You said you've got a memory. Can you remember a great building you saw or a great feeling you had? Do you pick up things like that? Not everybody does.
No, wait a minute. That was a great, great thing you just said. You said you got a memory. That was a good one, man. Now I've got to act like I got one.
You told me you had a memory.
Yeah, that was great, man. I like that line there.
Not everybody has a memory, though.
You know, Florida, I like Florida. California. The only thing I didn't like about California, the earthquakes ran me out of there, man. I was in an earthquake in the early 70s, and it rocked me. I said, no. I'm used to thunderstorms and all and tornadoes because you know they're coming. They let you know they're coming. But an earthquake, it just comes up on you, man. You know.
And that puts you off California.
That puts me off. I don't go there now. I don't like, when we go there, I like to work and get out of there quick as I can. I love the islands, any of the islands down in the Bahamas.
Have you been somewhere that you would recommend quietly to somebody to go to because it's just so romantic?
I went to this little place outside of Puerto Rico, Dominica. It's way down near Venezuela somewhere. And it was like first time I really went to a third world country. I didn't know what third world meant. I heard people say third world, and when I went down, they said, this is a third world country. I said, what's third world about it? What does that mean? And they said, because it's not industrialized like most places are, you know. And they had two major restaurants, Kentucky Fried Chicken and Subway. No major hotels. Their national product was bananas. And I saw some of the biggest palm trees I ever saw in my life, man. Matter of fact, they shot Pirates of the Caribbean down there. A lot of people, you wouldn't even see it on the map. But that would be a place that I tell somebody to go about romantic. I mean, there you got all of the up and down the coastline. If you could probably walk up and down the coastline naked. Nobody would even care. Write about everything you want to write about. So that would be a place, you know, I think. Somewhere like that.
Tell us about your latest musical project. I know you, being a keyboard player and a great singer, the last album was a real classic Soul Boys album. Loved it. But you got a new project, and you're suggesting, and we're going to hear a preview track from it, you're suggesting this is a bit more jazzy.
Yeah, I'm doing more piano playing in this.
So your heroes will be piano players then?
Oh, yeah. Les McCann, Ramsey Lewis, organ players, Charles Erdman, Big John Patton, even Oscar Peterson. You know, I mean, most of the guys that play, you know, I respect them all, you know.
But this new album then reflects the jazzier side of Ronnie, does it?
Yes, it's called The Jazz in Me.
Wrapped up in your eyes. everything my heart will not repair. When I'm making love to you, it's more than what I thought it meant. Sure enough, no, when love is good, I just can't let it go. Gonna do all that I can.
Exclusive preview of my choice from the forthcoming album from Ronnie McNear. Doesn't that sound good? I Want to Be Good to You. Right, coming up soon, it's Helen Mayhew, but before Helen and Dinner Jazz after the news, let me tell you, next week we start a really exciting series. It's the South Africa series, or the South African season, bringing in some guaranteed sunshine. We'll be talking in particular next week, thanks to Mike Vitti, with the boss of the bass, Marcus Miller. He's in London, he's in Manchester for Jazz FM next week. We'll be talking to him. He was one of the headliners at the South African Jazz Festival. Our man Mike Vitti was there. We'll be talking about music. We'll be talking about the sunshine of South Africa too. Ahead of all that though, we got the latest news, and then things get even better. It can only be Dinner Jazz with Helen Mayhew.
And relax. There's 50% off Vivo Collection sofas at DFS. Half price savings end Sunday. DFS, making every day more comfortable. Auto Glass Repair. Auto Glass.